This is the early edition with Phil Johnson and Gord Mazzutti on Kelowna's information station, AM 1150.
The early edition with Phil and Gord is for Dick's Pharmacists, your medication problem solvers. Visit us at our four Kelowna locations or online at dickspharmacists.com.
8:23 at the early edition on this Thursday, the 25th. The heat will hit you this afternoon, middle of the afternoon. The thermometer should be sitting on at about 34 degrees as you head home. Right now, delightful 21, 22 degrees, a fresh, invigorating start to the day. The beaches are jammed. The kids' water park at City Park, one of the best places to be mid-afternoon. The only place that I could think that would be better to be in the middle of the afternoon would be out on the water, flyboarding. We've all seen the video. It was viral. It was on YouTube, and I can still remember three or four people dropping it into my mailbox saying, Phil, you got to take a look at this. The video was of three or four guys, all that that had a Skidoo, Sea-Doo, Yamaha, whatever you want to call it, on a trailer, a personal watercraft. And as they launched those boats into the water and fired them up, something spectacular happened. Out of the water rose men, boys, teens, pilots, standing on a column, a pillar of water. And then the most amazing thing happened. There was four of them, and they started this on-the-lake, on-the-water ballet that was truly a sight to behold. Did a little investigating, found out that this was called flyboarding. Well, you know, some of us look at a video and say, isn't that cool? But others of us look at a video and say, I want to know more. And maybe I want to do something about it, and that somebody is Devin Spittle. He found out about flyboarding, watched it on YouTube, as I did. But the next thing, he's on a plane flying to Utah to find out everything, and he has now brought flyboarding to the Okanagan. Devin Spittle, good morning to you.
Good morning to you too, Phil.
I take my hat off to you. You're a young entrepreneur who said, I'm going to make something happen here on the lake in my backyard.
Well, that was a great introduction and a great summary. I appreciate that. Yeah, no, it was such an amazing video. I think it has about 8 million views now, and it just keeps rising.
Those guys look like they have found the ultimate freedom. They look like dolphins and porpoises.
Well, I couldn't even believe it was real when I first saw it on YouTube. The channel I was subscribed to posts a lot of really interesting videos, and these guys, I couldn't believe that was actually happening on these lakes, and I had to do it. For one, I had to do it, and two, I had to have everyone else do it too.
and everyone else had to do it too.
Exactly.
And you've just built a business.
Yeah.
So what's happening with flyboarding here on the Big Lake?
The Big Lake. Well, a lot of the people here. I'm getting a lot of tourists. I'm getting a lot of people from Alberta. A lot of people from Vancouver. It seems like the locals are a little hesitant, and Castanet's been helping a lot with that video that just got posted, but. I think the majority of people, they go on and they see this viral video, and there's a lot of pros there. There's a lot of flips. There's a lot of really extreme tricks going on. And I think people are a little intimidated when they see that.
But the reality is that's the height. That's the ultimate.
Exactly. So my whole goal recently has just been showing people this doesn't have to be an extreme, a crazy sport. It can be very leisure. For example, I took out a 67-year-old gentleman last week, and he did excellent. You don't have to go 35 feet up if you don't want to. So you can take it easy, or you can take it extreme.
Can you fall?
Yes, you can fall. If you fall forward, you actually will save yourself every time. Your feet will always slow you down with the jets.
Right.
Falling back's a little more uncomfortable, but as the instructor course that I was able to take, I'm able to see the warning signs and lower people down, so it doesn't hurt as much.
So you have some control through the throttle of the Skidoo, or the Sea-Doo, rather.
Yeah. Yep.
You have control with that throttle.
Yeah, exactly. With as an instructor, I prefer to have the control over the power. You can buy kits that allow the rider to control it, but for lessons, I prefer to actually control the rider.
Couple of minutes on this Thursday morning with Devin Spittle, who has brought flyboarding to the Big Lake just out here, working out off the beach, off of Manteo, and down off of the Grand. If I've been, or if I'm a snowboarder, or a skateboarder, longboarder, does any of that come to play?
If you've done any sport that requires balance, whether it be skiing, snowboarding, wakeboarding, you will be a complete natural on this. The learning curve is 5 to 10 minutes, and you're up in the air. It's very, very easy.
So the people who are doing this really are the tourists who are in town. And instead of going parasailing and standing on the deck of the parasail boat and going up, they're getting wet and having way more fun.
No, every single lesson I've done this season has been a success. Everyone who's gone has loved it, and they've just raved about it and sent me their reviews. There haven't been any injuries with this sport worldwide. People are loving it.
So do you put a hero camera on a helmet on their head?
Exactly.
Do you really?
Yeah, we do it. We've had a few of them break off because people will dive with them, but that doesn't work out too well. But getting up in the air, no, we do have some good GoPro footage with people climbing into the sky.
How cool is this? You get the best job in town, man.
I love it.
You've got the personal watercraft. You've got people who are discovering something that probably has them with a silly-ass grin on their face from ear to ear. And you get to spend the day on a watercraft out there on the water, just soaking up the rays and just with lots of laughs.
No, this is amazing. I couldn't ask for anything more, especially seeing people's faces after they do their first ride. Everyone loves it, and I'm just so happy to be a part of it.
How much?
It's $125 for a 30-minute flight, and it does scale down according to how many people and how long you want to go for.
Are you going to give me a guarantee that I guarantee you're going to fly before you leave the water?
I guarantee you will fly, or your money is back. I've never failed teaching people.
Devin Spittle, it's always a pleasure to meet young entrepreneurs who want to do something just a little bit different. Kudos to you.